The most important result of this research for me is that Russia is quite successful in many countries within the broader region to inflate its image and look stronger and more scary than it really is. When we see that in Bulgaria, in Serbia, but even in Slovakia and the Czech Republic, for example, Russia seems militarily superior compared to the West and the United States. I think it is an important result, and it pretty much is in line with the findings of previous research by Political Capital Institute in Hungary that also found that not only the military, but also the economic power and the political influence of Russia is highly overperceived, mystified, and exaggerated. The data reveals that on the one hand, history matters in shaping public opinion, because in the countries where the notion of the Slavic brotherhood and unity is stronger, there we can usually find more positive attitudes towards Russia, but also a stronger perception of Russia as a strategic partner and also as a military superior power, such as in countries and as Serbia, but even in Montenegro, in Bulgaria and Slovakia. On the other hand, the data also reveals that discourses matter and rhetorics, contemporary rhetorics, matter. Because, for example, in Hungary, where traditionally and historically the attitudes towards Russia are not very favorable, and also Hungary is not a Slavic country, we can see a gradual shift in the public opinion towards a more pro-Russian position. It's not independent of the dominant governmental rhetoric. And also a very interesting and important result that in Hungary, contrary to other countries, we can see more people among the youngsters who are in favor of having Russia as a strategic partner than in the elderly population. So it reveals that this is not something that is mainly rooted in the historical experiences or the nostalgia towards the communist past. The most important task of NATO, the United States and the West in more general in the region is to try to demystify Russia. If in many countries, Russia, the country that spends only 1/10 of what the United States spends on an annual basis on its military, is perceived still superior to the United States, it really shows that Russia is highly successful in inflating its image. And to counterbalance that, there is a need for more self-confidence on the side of the West to try to persuade the public that that this perception is false on the one hand. On the other hand, there is also, I think, a need for politicians in the respective countries to talk about the weaknesses of the Russia model as well. Russia can be perceived as extremely powerful, even in challenging times.